All right, so now we're really getting down to it. Next up is this piece of white oak. This is the only log, only of the large logs that were brought here that I had any assistance loading. This was loaded on the trailer with a forklift. The saddest part about this log is it used to go out to around here, and it was all clear down to here, and somebody started cutting it up for firewood rounds. And this cut right here they made, they weren't able to make it all the way through the log. And I was hoping that they didn't get like super far into the log, that way if the cut was straight across, I could still get full length boards up until a certain point, and then I'd get like 16 inches shorter. But this cut is almost all the way through, so this is gonna have to come off anyway. So what I'm gonna do with this section is cut up into cookies, and I'll have a separate video on cutting and drying cookies. But I think I'm gonna try and get this whole thing over to the mill in one piece. I'm not really sure where this cut ends right now. I think it's towards the bottom. But I'm gonna start moving it over there and we'll see how it goes. So this is a white oak log. It's 33 inches down there at the butt, and it's a little over 24 inches at the top side. And there's a bunch of crotches in here, so it should be fairly interesting grain. So the place I picked this up was right by the stone place. They did like sculptures and things like that. And they had a forklift there, so the guys helped me with it. But the log pile was across a gravel area, and the area they needed the forklift to ride on was paved. And that was about 100 feet away from this log where it was sitting. So this was dragged behind a guy's truck about 100 feet through gravel. So this is gonna be very dirty in the bark. I'm gonna try and pull off what I can, but I'll go over the whole bark with compressed air and a leaf blower, just to try and get as much junk out of the bark as possible. Nice. So I got this thing up here, and a couple of things now. So first off, I want to position this log in the best orientation. And I'm thinking, since this is the biggest limb coming off of here, it should provide the most crotch figure. I want to do what I can to make this the focal point of the slab and have the crotch figure from this limb be the most pronounced in all the slabs. There's a lot of other little limbs coming off of here, nothing this big. So the other limbs will produce some crotch figure here and there, but this is gonna produce, hopefully, the most. Well, that means that this whole log needs to rotate 90 degrees that way. And that's probably a good thing because this side of the log is pretty much flat, or it's the flattest area of the log. There aren't any limbs coming out of this plane here. So if I roll this over, it should sit pretty flat on the bed for the longest amount of time. Now, before I start rolling this thing, since I do have to do it pretty much by hand, I'm going to remove the section down here that I'm going to cut up into cookies just to get some of the weight off of here. I left it on up to this point because it is a fairly flat area, so it made moving the log around, sliding it around a little bit easier. But let me just show you what's going on over here. So here's the partial cut from whoever's cutting this in the firewood. The cut over here, it stops at this point, and then if you come up to where the other side is, up top here, it's over here. So it goes from right there to up in there. So it's kind of at an angle. So I'm gonna do my best with a chainsaw to come in here and just kind of follow the kerf here. Alright, so I'm hoping I can get this thing slid kind of over here and get it behind the saw. That way I can get it out of the way for now and not have to worry about trying to get it back up here when I want to actually cut this thing. Okay, just park that over here. Man, that's not light at all. Alright, so not a whole lot missing here, about an inch worth. A little bit of mold in here already. Ice and water. There's plenty of things to grab onto for the jack. Starting with this limb here. Limb is straight off the side. That's very good. So what I'm gonna have to do is somehow scoot this thing that way so this gets behind the rails again, and then pick up this side probably like at least 12 inches, 6 to 12 inches, to get it in line with the other side, and then it can start sawing. So I think I'll start with the scooting. So the log diameter down here at the skinny end here, 26 inches, 67 centimeters. And then up here on this end is a bit over 3 feet. I think it's 37 inches, about 37 inches, so 94 centimeters. Pretty big. This log rocks just a little bit, so I'm gonna pick this up a bit and then slide this wedge thing underneath here. And that should help to stabilize it. Yeah, that's a lot better. Yeah. How about that, huh? Pretty nice. Got some figuring up here above this limb. Got a pretty cool bullseye thing going on here. So just like that ash log we did, I think, last week, we're gonna have the bullseye pattern for the first few slabs until we get down towards the pith. And then we'll start seeing the big crotch figure from this guy being exposed. But there should be some figure in here as well. There should be some, looks like some quilting figure. There should be some quilting figure in here. There's the quilting lumps in a lot of spots throughout the log, so there should be some figure from those. We shall see. So again, I think on this one I'm going to cut these at 10/4, so I'm going to get the saw set for that. So the saw is currently at 32 1/4 ish, so I'm going to come down 2.5 inches, and I'll just check with a tape measure as well. It's 10/4, 2.5 inches. All right, let's make another cut. I'll probably make a couple cuts just to get things going. That's one of the questions I had on the last video. Was like, why do I make all the cuts and then, or make a few cuts and then move them out of the way? That's just to keep the unitasking. I can stay focused on one thing at once. If I'm sawing, I can just saw. If I'm moving, I can just move. Just makes things a little more efficient for me. Not that this is the most efficient thing in the world being one person. So I think I'm gonna call it good there with two cuts. I wanna change this blade. The blade that's on here right now, it's cutting fine, but I wanna get a new blade on there. So once I get to the really wide stuff, it doesn't want to wander no matter how slightly dull it is. So I'm gonna actually stack this over here for now. This is out of the way enough. Oh, this is cool. Oh, wait till you see this. Man, it's hot. I didn't think I'd say that for a long time. I'm actually hot. This is cool. Look at this. Man, that's nice. Blade is still cutting flat though. That's good. Man, that's beautiful. That's a really nice cut. Wow. I like this bullseye thing. That's cool. So it's the next day. The weather isn't quite as nice today. It's pretty overcast. So even though the temperature is about the same, it doesn't feel nearly as warm as it did yesterday. Yesterday I feel like I was going to start sweating everywhere. But that's all right. The overcast sky should help make filming this a little bit easier than trying to fight with all of the bright sun. So hopefully things will be easier to see. Oh, this is cool. Oh, yeah. This is getting really neat. Look at that. Man, that's beautiful. Starting to get a little bit of crotch figure in here as we get into this limb here. Still have some pretty cool bullseyes, but this is a lot clearer than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to have a lot more knots in it, but it turns out that there really isn't. They're very small and they're all solid. I don't think I've measured the length yet. So almost 7 feet long. Yep, this is getting even better. Oh, that's a good one. Pretty spectacular looking. Let's take a look. How about that, huh? There's some crotch figure through there. Still surprising me how clean these boards are. They are very clear. For this tree having so many limbs coming off of it, that's you know, over 12 inches of all clear, straight grain, beautiful white oak. There's even some curl here. You can see this big curl coming through here. That's cool. And up here, get a little double bullseye knot kind of thing going on there. Oh boy. It's got some suction. Okay. How about that, huh? A little bit of crotch figure there. Got some really nice straight grain through here. It's all quarter sawn, so it's hard to see through the rough cut, but there is some ray flecking through here. Just beautiful stuff. I think I might like the other one better though. That slab here might be my favorite one. I'm thinking this is my favorite. At least so far. There's not a whole lot left on here. There's one, two, three slabs left maybe, and some kind of taper bit. But yeah, check that out. That is fantastic. So I have to adjust this one clamp over here. Still feels pretty stable, so I'm hoping to get, should be able to get one cut and then have to move this clamp. But if I get one cut out of here, I should be able to flip this thing over. There's not a whole lot going on down here anymore. So that's probably going to be the last. There's probably two slabs left at full length, and then I'll have a partial tapered slab. So I was able to clear the clamp down in here, so I was able to get another cut out of this. Now I can go ahead and take these two slabs off of here and try and roll this thing over and get the last full length slab, and then I'll probably get a few pieces from this tapered piece down here. All right, here's this one. Still really clear. Like, I was expecting a lot more weirdness going on in here. It's nice. I got some nice figure through here. A little bit of the last bit of crotch figure there. But very nice white oak, that's for sure. All right, I think for these ones, I'm just gonna try and drag them over here. It's not that far. So I know the last video people asked me why I didn't use rollers to get these things onto the stack. And I have used rollers in the past. That's exactly what these are. These are for rolling slabs around. One thing I don't like about using rollers is things can go wrong pretty quickly with these. If the slabs get any kind of momentum as you're trying to put them on the stack, they're gonna fall off the stack. And well, I guess I have my log trailer to help me pick them back up, but if I didn't, if that slab hits the ground, there's no way for me to get it back up on top of the stack. So I kind of only use these as a last resort, I guess. Just for that reason. Like what's about to happen right here. Yeah, I like this. See? Just gets it going. And your only choice is to get out of the way. Luckily these aren't, I mean they're heavy, but I can still lift them. I'll lift one end at least, not both of them. I can't lift the whole slab alone, but I can lift one end of it pretty easily. Only the stack was like 3 feet closer. Too bad, I guess. Now, stickers. Gotta go find some more stickers. This one at least looks significantly lighter. Let's see if that's the case. I don't think it's the case at all. Huh. Not too bad. Oh, I didn't even show you what it looks like. Totally forgot. Here's the one I just pulled off the stack. And here's the one that's on the top of the log now. Also pretty cool. Hey, that's pretty cool, a little burl. Ugh. So one of the things I want to point out on this one is this blue staining here. And that staining is from when this limb was on here. This used to be, I don't know which way it went, but this is that limb here. And on this limb there was a piece of wire wrapped around the branch, I guess probably for hanging something from the tree, I guess. But the iron in the metal reacted with the tannins in the white oak, causing this blue stain. So I knew that there was at least metal, well, I could see this stuff. But then when I cut this limb off to trim it up, I found the staining. So kind of an interesting thing with white oak is if you see the staining and you don't see any metal anywhere, there might be some metal somewhere. So that's a good indicator of that. Luckily here, I'm lucky there wasn't any other metal inside of this tree, just that one limb, but kind of a cool little thing, I guess. So I'm gonna get this slab out of the way. Take a look at the next one. Oh, this is cool. This has got some really neat bark inclusions. Here, check this out. Isn't that cool? That's that one. And this is the one I just took off of there. Also has some interesting bark inclusions as well. Pretty cool. Looks like I probably can get another cut out of this. Something at least, maybe a piece of 8-quarter. So here is that first piece of 8-quarter. Pretty cool piece of wood. Some nice bark inclusion. Get that blue stain again there. Get this on the stack. The other one's pretty small. I guess small is relative. Not super big, but still a decent chunk of wood there. So these slabs will sit over here in my staging area until I get everything else kind of set up for all of my stacks. That's what these ones are for too. Those are gonna get stacked. Those are gonna get stacked on top of some logs I haven't cut yet. This will be its own stack, I think, just due to the kind of odd shorter size. But this was a cool log. It fought me quite a bit of the way, but it is now 10 pieces of 10 quarter and 2 pieces of 8 quarter. So that's pretty good. That's a good amount of wood. So thank you as always for watching. I greatly appreciate it. If you have any questions on the sawmill or anything back in the shop, please feel free to leave me a comment. As always, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have. And until next time, happy woodworking.